I'm going to show you how to create a pivot table using a VBA macro. So I have equipment sales here, and I have a bunch of different types of them, and I've got them against different salespeople. Now, it would be perfect to run a pivot table to see what the sales for each individual was. First of all, this sounds, it's not logical, but it makes sense to me. So is I always create a pivot table to see where I want to place things. So what I'm going to do is I have clicked on my table here, and I'm going to insert, and I'm going to insert pivot table. And so I'm going to make it on a new sheet, and so here we go. And so I know that I would like to have the salespeople in the rows, and I would like to have the type of sales in the columns, and finally I would like them to total the amount, so that will be in the sum of values here, and that's the total of the amount. So now I have figured out where I want things to go. It's easier to figure it out before you actually write the VBA. This is in position one of the row fields. This is in position two, or position one of the column fields. And then we're summing up the data is what we're doing here. So remember that, and then we will write a code to do the same procedure. Okay, so now let's go to our developer tab, and let's go to my Visual Basic. And so I will explain what I have done here. So you have to define the worksheets. So our pivot table worksheet, our data, which is our sheet one, and our cache and our table cache. And I will include all these so that you don't have to copy them down. I will include all these in the description so you don't have to copy them down. And so the first thing that we're doing here is we are defining where the table on sheet one is. And so we're just going by the last col or the last row and the last column, and we're defining that as our table. And then we're setting our PCache, where we're getting our data from. And then we're setting PTable equals the PCache, create a pivot table. Table destination equals pivot sheet, cells 1, 1, table equals table name equals pivot table. Now what we have created a sheet name pivot table, and if there's a pivot name table sheet already there, it's going to delete it. And so then here we have what I was telling you to remember. It is so active sheet pivot table, pivot field salesperson, which we have here, orientation XL row position one. And then we have active sheet pivot table, pivot fields type, XL column field position one. And then what we're doing is we're totaling up the sum of the amounts. So we have active pivot table, add fields, active sheet pivot table, pivot fields amount. That's where we're getting it from. And what we're doing with this is we're summing the amount. And then we do end sub. And so let's run this. And so we'll F8 through it. So why don't I bring this over to this side here so you can see it go a little bit. So we're going to continue to F8. So now it's created our pivot table here. And now it's going to put in the salespeople's names. And then it's going to put in the type as the column. And then the last thing it's going to do is it's going to total up the sum of the amount. And so there we go. There's our pivot table done for you. So basically what you would do is you could change this sheet of data at any time and just run the pivot table again. It would go automatically exactly the way you wanted it. So that's how you make a pivot table with VBA. Please subscribe.